News today involving just about every person who will be hopping on a plane from the holidays on. Folks, grab your portable devices. Here's Haley Francis.
The next time you hop on a flight, you may not be asked to stow your electronic devices before takeoff. The Federal Aviation Administration is changing that old rule, and flight attendants everywhere are probably relieved to no longer have to tell you to turn off your e-device.
Fasten your seatbelts, make sure your chair is in the upright and locked position, and keep that cell phone, tablet, and e-reader out and powered on. We're exaggerating, of course, but in the very near future, flight attendants may no longer be asking you to turn off your portable electronic devices. After 50 years of the FAA maintaining your electronics are dangerous and interfere with the plane's communication and navigation equipment, they did a study last year and found they were wrong.
The committee determined that most commercial airplanes can tolerate radio interference from portable electronic devices.
Well, that's good news for those of us who want to stay plugged into our iPads or tablets, our e-readers, or our smartphones to play downloaded games. But there still may be some safety concerns.
My overall take on this is that the rules were always kind of silly because they were sort of arbitrary and capricious, but I did understand one component of the rule. I think it's important that people pay attention during the pre-flight briefing and during takeoff and landing. If people are reading an iPad or a Kindle and the airplane starts to begin to crash, there are sounds that you can feel when the airplane will be kind of flying weird, or it'll be taking off and not accelerating correctly. If somebody's deep in a book, they're not going to pay attention to that.
There are a few exceptions to the looser guidelines. Connecting to the internet remains prohibited when the plane is less than 10,000 feet in the air. And don't expect to be chatting on your cell phone during flight time, only texting if you can get a signal. And that's because a ban on using voice communications still remains in effect.
Now, before the new rule takes effect, airlines must demonstrate their planes can handle the potential interference from e-devices. JetBlue Airways and Delta Airlines are among the first to eagerly sign on for those new tests. That is expected to happen pretty quickly. As soon as the end of the year, you may see the new looser policies in most of the nation's airline fleet. Of course, for now, passengers should continue to follow instructions from their flight crew.
We now know the cause of